Good afternoon. It's Wednesday, February 7th. Got off work several hours early, so I'm going to cook this frozen pizza that I got a while back at Aldi for lunch. For a couple reasons. One, because since I worked less, I don't want to go out and buy food. I want to save money. And two, because if it's good, I can get more, because I'll be going to Aldi today. For right now, I got home, and I've just sort of laid out on the floor with some D&D books, planning not the current campaign, but the next one. Not really planning, just sort of going through ideas and getting stuff put together, thinking about it. Thinking about it with notes and cross-referencing multiple books. At this point, I do hope that my players manage to finish off the current campaign relatively fast. Because I don't really know what the end goal for this current campaign is. I don't. I know that, like, another step towards that, they just, like, skipped a big chunk of by what they did in the last session. So, I mean, they're getting there. But, not really sure what the actual goal that they're going towards is. We'll see. But not only because I want to, I'm excited for the next game, but also because kind of the goal, and I mean, obviously there's more than just finishing the game, but when I finish getting the furniture, that'll be a new table. And the new table is going to be a little bigger. And the goal is to be able to have Ryan join. Now, I used to run games, I'd have, 7, 8, 9 players. I mean, I've done that. But several friends have moved, out of town, and so they're no longer available. And some others just, they have lives where they're just typically not available, and that's fine. But I have one friend that is often available, but because of the small table and the small room that I was in before and all that, I just couldn't regularly have them in a game because it's difficult and uncomfortable to sit around. But I'm getting a table that's a bit longer, and so the hope is that it'll work just fine, and Ryan will be able to join us too. So that's another reason I'm kind of excited for this next campaign. Anyways, I think it just beeped that it's finished preheating, so I'm gonna go get the pizza put in. And I do gotta say, my plates always seem like they look too small. The pizza's just sort of hanging off the edge. It's almost like it wasn't designed for an entire pizza to go on the plate at once. I don't know why it wouldn't be, but it's what it seems like. The pizza was all right. I mean, I finished it, and it'll keep me full. I might purchase another one, just because I think they were pretty cheap, and as far as having something really cheap that I can just make the decision of, okay, I'm gonna have this, but I'm not gonna, like, stock up on them as, like, a regular option. But yeah, it might be something just as far as a quick, cheap meal. It definitely served as that, and that's what I needed today, so it did serve its purpose. So I, finished up some work, basically cataloging monsters from the monster manual that I could use in an Underdark campaign. And largely the idea behind doing the campaign in that setting is there are a number of monsters that I have never used, certainly since we've done 5th edition, some of which ever. In any of the games I've ran in the many years I've been running D&D. There are a number of monsters I've just never used. And a lot of them fit into this sort of theme, so that's kind of why I'm... I've never done, like, an Underdark kind of thing. I've never had a world that has that sort of underground cavernous system. At least not to my recollection. Not at that sort of scale. For one, I don't know if I can map it, if it's, because it's like a map, it's in three-dimensional space, so, bit of a deterrent, but oh well, should be fun all the same. So I did that, and I've read some more Xanathar's Guide to Everything, trucking my way through that, and I did sit down and edit another vlog, a bit of a longer one, so that's good. And it's getting close to when I would normally be off work now. And I think, I just got some laundry and I'm gonna head up to Aldi. pick some things up. Let's go.
And I do gotta say, I did get the ad a few days ago. And there are definitely some things I'm looking forward to in here. It's gonna be a bit of an expense with some of the non-food things today. So far I've already gotten some stuff. Basics, there have been some various noodle bowls, and I'll try the sweet and sour sauce. It's an ironing mat, which would be like an ironing board, only you put it on top of like the dryer to use it. And a trunk organizer. I'm just now about to get to...
Looks good.
Yeah. Here's what I'm here for. Tools. A wok. And wok tools. That's what I've been needing.
And they didn't actually have everything they were supposed to. Sounded like some of the stuff didn't arrive. I'm hearing someone else talking to the employee there. They're hoping it'll be in tomorrow, whatever. I'm thinking everything that I wanted that was non-food was there. But there were a couple, because it was sort of like an Asian food week kind of thing. So yeah, and I'll show off what I got when I get it home, but I definitely got some things I don't probably need, but that I like to have. So in addition to bread, milk, and orange juice, which I pretty much get fairly regularly now, I got a few more food things. I had a sweet and sour marinade and dressing, which I don't have high hopes for, but figure worth a shot. And I did a little frozen vegetable mini egg roll option that can be done in a fryer. Got that. Then I got three different flavors of these. One with no spicy indicator, one with a little spicy indicator, and one with a whole bunch of spicy indicator. They're like noodle bowls that should be quick and easy to put together. That could be interesting to try. And they give me, like, more than half a year to get around to them with the Best Buy date they have on there. And I got plenty of non-food things today as well. I got, like I said, this ironing mat. And largely the idea is that this is very small. I have an iron, but I don't have an ironing board. And ironing boards tend to be pretty big. And so it's a solution to not have to have a full-size ironing board. And this folding trunk organizer has Velcro on the bottom, so it'll stick down in the trunk of my car and make it easy for me to have a couple components, because I have a bunch of stuff right now that just sort of rolls back and forth in my trunk. Just stuff that I feel like I need to have with me, you know, couple of travel blankets, extra set of clothes. Just the kind of, you know, things that you should always have in case something goes wrong. I got a couple sets of wooden sort of utensils. Let me show off what's in them. Each set contains 5 different things. And in general, they weren't the highest quality. Some of them have little splintery bits on the side and such. But you know what? I have only like a few wooden spoons right now, and all but like one of them is like cracking, so they're better than that. I got a set of 2 wooden cutting boards, because right now I don't even know where I put them. They're back there. I have these plastic ones that function, but that I'm not a huge fan of. And then I got a wok and some wok utensils, which I don't need immediately, but I do have plans for things I eventually want to learn how to cook, and that will be useful for some of those. So, plus it's cool. But yeah, so definitely one of the weeks where I spent more on non-food than food. And I was looking at the ad. They had the ad for next week, and they have the little mini fryer. So I bought that fryer a week or so ago. I still haven't opened it. And my mom, the other day when I was over there, found out that her larger fryer had messed up in storage. Basically, her microwave, someone had stored it with oil in it, and it had sprung a leak. So, wasn't fun finding out that, but ultimately also it meant it's no good. So she was thinking of getting one. If she hasn't already gotten one of those and she still wants it, I might say, hey, give me the $5. Give her that one. And, or they get, whatever, and basically get my $5 back from her and get the smaller one. Because I don't really need that big of one. A small one is good enough. It's just me. That's definitely bigger than my needs. So I'd be fine with a smaller one. And so if she's still needing the big one, I may try and trade around and do that. So I'm uploading a video game video. Just because it's last one came out a week ago, and that way I'll at least be covered for this week. Don't have to worry about it. And I spoke with my mom, and I was like, oh, hey, when can I come over? So I gotta check some things out of the house, and I figured I'd like to see her. And which she arranged things, and it sounds like the plan is to go out to eat with them this evening. Hopefully not too late, but still nice. So we'll be working that out some point, so that'll be cool. Just got the call. Time to head over to Mom's, and we'll go out to eat. Mom wanted to try a new place. There's this Native Grill and Wings. It just opened up. It says established 1979. I'd never heard of it. Yes, we're gonna try this. But it was really loud inside. It's just a big open room, so like any noise in there just echoed, and like there was nothing for sound to bounce off of or anything. So it was just a noisy place. But I had wings. I got whatever, a pound of wing of boneless wings, half like medium buffalo and half honey barbecue, both of which were very good. And then I also had some potato skins, which my mom ordered because she wanted a couple of them. My mom also got some boneless wings, a salt and vinegar, which were all right. I tried one of them, and she only had a few of those as well. She just wasn't hungry. She rarely is. But the rest of those are now gonna be my lunch for tomorrow. So I got that taken care of from that, which is good. Otherwise, headed home. It's almost 9. I am certainly appreciating my new schedule right now, that I don't have to stress out about it. You know, having bedtime at 9:40 instead of 9 makes a big difference as far as just what I'm able to do with my day, I suppose. So it gives me a lot of grace with that. And but ultimately, I'm probably gonna go home and pretty much go to bed. I already got a couple of vlogs edited today, taken care of. I uploaded the video I needed to get uploaded, so all that's taken care of. I just pretty much relax, and that's kind of what I want to do. So yeah, I'm probably gonna go home and go to bed. That being said, thank you for joining me, and joining me as my journey continues. Bye.